Hello friends, this is session number 9, okay, and it is regarding evaporation, okay. So we are doing session 9, okay, and the topic is matter in our surroundings, right? Matter in our surroundings. This is our last topic of this chapter. Okay, so let's try to understand what is evaporation. See, many times students, they get confused with the word evaporation and vaporization. Both the words are different, and both the terms are different. Their meaning is also different. Okay, so be very careful in understanding this term. Okay, what in which terms they get confused? Evaporation and evaporation and vaporization. Yesterday I have told you about vaporization, and I think in the session number 8.2 or in 8.3 I have given the description about vaporization. Okay, vaporization or boiling, you can say. Okay, but this is evaporation. See, in both the cases you have to understand that vaporization is change of liquid to gaseous state after boiling or during boiling. Okay, when once the boiling starts, then the change of liquid state to gaseous state is known as vaporization. But in evaporation, what happens? During the process of evaporation, liquid changes to vapor state or steam. Okay. At any temperature but below its boiling point. Understood the difference? In this case, the vaporization was taking place during boiling point. As soon as a liquid reaches its boiling point, vaporization starts taking place. But in this case, what is happening? Liquid changes to vapor. In this case also, the same thing is happening, that liquid is changing to vapor state. But it is not waiting to gain for its boiling point to reach. Okay, before boiling point only. It at any temperature it evaporates or it changes to vapor. That is known as evaporation. Understood? In vaporization, the boiling point is required. As soon as the boiling point reaches, vaporization starts, the liquid changes to vapor. But in this case, in evaporation, liquid changes to vapor at any temperature but below its boiling point. Understood? Now, two things you have to keep in your mind. First of all, that evaporation is change of liquid to vapor. ठीक है? In this also it is same. Vaporization. In vaporization, what is happening? In vaporization, liquid changes to vapor. In this also, liquid changes to vapor. Okay. But in this case, what is happening? Liquid changes to vapor at any temperature. It occurs at any temperature. Okay. below boiling point, below its boiling point. Okay, in this case what is happening, it occurs at only at boiling point. Okay, occurs at boiling point. What is boiling point? Boiling point is the point at which the temperature point at which the liquid starts boiling. Okay, and when once it starts boiling, it starts changing to vapor. Okay, it starts changing to gaseous state. Okay, so you have to remember these two points, that in evaporation there is change of liquid to vapor state, in vaporization there is change of liquid to vapor state. So both the processes, the phenomenon in both the cases, the happening is same only. What is happening? That liquid is changing to vapor, but the process is different in regards of temperature. That in this case it can take place at any temperature below its boiling point, whereas it is going to take place only at boiling point. Understood? One more thing you have to keep in mind is that in evaporation is a surface phenomena. Evaporation is a surface phenomena. Whereas vaporization is a bulk phenomenon. Understood? What is the difference between these two? In bulk phenomenon, what is happening in bulk phenomena? The whole particles of the liquid, they start taking place, they start vibrating at their places after once they reach the boiling point, or after once they gain kinetic energy through the heating process. Okay, but in this case what is happening, in this case only the surface particles of the liquid, they get energy and they gain energy and they escape into the air or escape into the gaseous form. Now, what is happening actually in case of evaporation? In this, we have understood the mechanism how the liquid is changing to vapor state. But in this case, what is happening without heat? How it is going to change? Because it is not required any, it doesn't require any external source of heat. Without external source of heat, only it can evaporate. Anything can evaporate. Any liquid can evaporate. So, what is the mechanism? How is it possible that without heat, without the requirement of heat, only they gain kinetic energy and the process takes place? So, let us understand this. See what happens in case of evaporation. First of all, you have to keep in mind that the molecules of a liquid, they randomly move. Okay, they are in random motion. Okay, and the particles have different kinetic energies also. Okay, so what is there in vaporization? Sorry, not vaporization, evaporation. In evaporation, what happens that the molecules are in random motion. Okay, molecules or particles, you can say molecules are in random motion. Also, they have what? These molecules, they have kinetic energies. Okay, molecules have different kinetic energies. Okay, so these molecules, they are having different kinetic energies also. Now what? There are two things acting upon these particles. What are those two things? First one is the intermolecular forces are acting between them, molecular forces. Okay, and the second thing is the pressure which is around in air, pressure due to air. Okay, so there are two things, pressure due to air, and so what is happening here? Actually, what happens that in this case, the liquid, suppose a liquid is there, okay, a source of liquid is there, suppose, and the particles are closely, not so very closely packed, they are loosely packed, but they are able to move in all directions. These particles are able to move in all directions, okay, they are in random motion, they are randomly moving. From here to here to here to here, in all direction they are able to move. Okay, what is happening during movement? They collide with each other. During movement there is the possibility of collision. टकराने के chances होते हैं, collision के टकराने के chances ज़्यादा होते हैं, and that is why what is happening that due to collision the kinetic energy, since they all are having kinetic energy because they are moving, you can understand that they are having kinetic energies, these molecules, they are having kinetic energies in them, but sorry. But what is happening that during collision, when they collide with each other, okay, when they collide with each other, the kinetic energy is not lost. But what is happening? The kinetic energy is transferred from one molecule to other molecule. So one, if one is losing its energy, then the other one is gaining that kinetic energy. If one of the particle is losing its kinetic energy, then other particle is gaining its kinetic energy. And such collisions are known as elastic collisions. We call such collisions as elastic collisions. What type of collisions are these? Elastic collisions, in which, what is elastic collision? In elastic collision, after collision, when two particles, they collide with each other, after collision one gains the energy and the other one loses its energy. Okay, so because we know that energy can neither be created nor be lost, so you can understand that total energy remains the same. But what is happening here, that one, after collision, one of the particle gains energy whereas the other particle loses its energy. Okay, so during this collision, what is happening, that these particles, they are, some of the particles which are gaining energy, they become more active and they become more energetic, so that they are able to overcome the intermolecular forces between them, as well as the pressure which is there due to air. What is happening, that some of the molecules which gain energy, some of the molecules or some of the particles which gain energy after collision, okay, they gain such much amount of energy that they overcome the intermolecular forces between them. They overcome the intermolecular forces between them. Also, they overcome the pressure exerted by the air in the surrounding. Okay, so after overcoming these two forces, these particles, they escape into the air. They escape into the air and in the form of vapor, because they leave the bonding of liquid here. Why? Because they gain energy and they become so much energetic that they are able to overcome their bonding, and they break the bonding in between the particles. They break the bonding and they move into the air, escape into the air and in the vapor form. So this is how evaporation takes place. Now after this, what happens? As soon as these particles, the particles which gain energy and move in the atmosphere by changing themselves to vapor state, what is happening behind in the molecules? These molecules, since they have lost their energy during the collision period, what happened, that cooling effect is applied here. This liquid becomes cooler. this liquid becomes cooler. Why is it so? Because they have already lost their energies to these particles which have escaped into the atmosphere. Understood? Okay, so this process is known as evaporation, and this is how evaporation occurs. Okay, now how cooling occurs, that also I have told you. We can see a few more examples of cooling effect, where the cooling is where the evaporation takes place and how cooling is observed there. For example, you can write here cooling effect of evaporation. So cooling effect of evaporation, you can see the perfumes. When you take the spirit or perfume on your palm or on the back of your skin, what happens? As soon as you pour, you feel cooling effect. Okay, or you, and nowadays sanitizers are very much popular. You can see that sanitizers, as soon as you put the spray sanitizer in your hand, what is happening? You feel cooling effect is felt by you, isn't it? Why is that so? It is because the skin, we are having a temperature, our skin is having some temperature, and as soon as we put that spirit on our palm or on our skin, so it takes the heat from the skin. Okay, the particles of that spirit, it takes the heat energy from this, and it takes the heat energy and it evaporates. And what is happening? The part from where it has taken the heat, suppose it is here, so the part from where it has taken the heat, that particular part becomes cooler. You feel very cool over there. Understood? Similarly, So this is the case of spirit, okay, or in the case of earthen pots. Why do we keep water in earthen pots? मटके में पानी रखते हैं. Why do we keep earthen pots at homes during summer season? To keep water in them. But what happens after that? When we keep water in earthen pots, what is happening? That in earthen pots, you can see that pores are made there in the pots. Okay, little pores are there. What is happening through these pores? The water is, the vaporization takes place. Evaporation takes place, not vaporization, sorry again. Evaporation takes place. And due to evaporation, what is happening? These pores, through the help of these pores, that evaporation takes place due to the latent heat is there in the atmosphere, which is being utilized by the water, and it changes to water vapor, and the water in the pot becomes cooler. Understood? The water in the pot becomes cooler. Okay. There are more examples. You must have seen that how the sweat is there in our bodies, and we feel during summer it brings a cooling effect on our skin, all because sweat of our bodies, they take the energy, or you can say the heat from our skin. And then what is happening, that as soon as they take the heat from our skin, they change to vapor state, and we feel cooler. Okay, our body is cooler behind. Okay, it is left behind cool. Okay, so these are the few examples of evaporation, and you can further think about it, you can discuss about it, and if you have any problem throughout the chapter, you can ask me anytime in any of the comment box. You can give your you can put your questions, and you can have any query. So with this we are going to finish the chapter. A few terms are there, I think if it is not being dealt by me, if it is not done by me, I'll try to come up with that video, and if not, then we'll go with another chapter. We'll start with another chapter. I'm having three series here. One series is about chemistry, the second series is about physics, and the third series is related to mathematics. So if you have any problem, if you have any doubt in any particular chapter, you can ask, and I'll be coming up with a video of that particular chapter. But right now I'm going to start with my maths series with basic foundations from the basics of the classes, and two three videos will be on basics, and then I'll start with something more. Thank you.